Consider this procedure P, which prints the integers in the range 1 through n. We have deliberately put local variable t in the body of the loop, although it isn't necessary, in order to make the point later on. Now consider the call P of 5. When this call is executed, a box is created called the frame for the call. It contains all information needed to execute the call. This information includes the parameters of the method, in this case n, the local variables declared in the method body, k and t, and a return address, something to indicate where the call occurred in the program, so it is known where to continue after the call is finished. We show the return address as a pointer, named RA, to just after the call. That's how we show it when we are executing a call. The computer may do it differently when the computer is executing a call. Note that all three variables initially contain a query, a question mark, because these variables are not initialized to anything when the frame is first created. This is different from a field of a newly created object, which contains a default value that depends on the type of the field. Other information may be necessary. For example, some methods, like setHour, appear in objects, like object T. The call then names the object that contains the method being called. In this case, the frame for the call contains not only the parameters, local variables, and return address, but also a pointer to the object in which the method resides, so that the fields and methods of the object can be used. To keep things simple, we won't deal with this case. Our examples will use only methods that contain only parameters and local variables, and not fields. One learns how a statement is executed because it allows one to draw important conclusions from it. We haven't completed the algorithm for executing a method call. We only showed its first step. And yet, think of the following. The creation of the frame for the call creates the parameters and local variables. If the computer is executing the call, it allocates space for the parameters and local variables in the first step. We leave you, then, to answer the following question. When, during a call of procedure P, is space allocated for local variable T? Is it allocated every time the repetend, meaning the loop body, is executed and deallocated when the repetend is finished?